Hello everyone, this is Stacy, and welcome to another Monday vlog. So over the weekend I hit 300,000 subscribers on this channel, which is a milestone that I honestly never even dreamed was possible. I'm so amazed at the support that this channel has right now, and as kind of a thank you, I thought I would do a video that has been very requested, which is a technical setup of all of the stuff that I have to record my videos. And what I want to say before this video starts is that in no way do you have to purchase this equipment in order to have a successful YouTube channel. If you have been on this channel for a while, or if you have gone back and watched some of my previous videos, you know that the quality has not always been that great. I recorded for a very long time on just a laptop with a simple gaming headset, and I had pretty poor audio quality during some episodes of Hexit. I think you see that I have 6 FPS. 6 FPS. So all of this equipment that you're about to see is stuff that I have invested in after, well after I reached 100,000 subscribers. Speaking of that, here is my 100,000 silver play button that I got from YouTube. But yeah, all of this stuff is stuff that I invested in once YouTube became an actual job for me, which is such a dream and such an amazing opportunity that I'm so thankful for. But I definitely recommend trying to put up videos with the equipment that you have and buying better equipment once you have a lot of subscribers. You don't need... I'm gonna sneeze. Anyway, like I kind of proved, I suppose, as long as people enjoy your videos, they will watch them, you know, and they will forgive your sort of poor quality, and then, you know, spend the big bucks on equipment once you know that this is something you're going to be doing for a long time, and there are a lot of people who are watching your videos. Anyway, okay, so let's get right into it. I guess we will start with the obvious, the computer. Look at my sweet background. This is a 27-inch iMac. It's the biggest iMac you can get, and a lot of people are going to comment that I should have a PC, and I know that a PC is traditionally what's better for gaming, especially non-Minecraft games are traditionally always on a PC. The thing about that is that I have worked on a Macintosh for many, many years before I started gaming, and it's just what I'm used to, and so for me to switch to a PC definitely would have been difficult, and I would have had to, I think it would have slowed me down from just continuing to build my channel. So I went with a Mac, and I added a lot of upgrades to it. I'm not going to list them out here in the video. I will put all of it in the description below, but I'm pretty happy with the performance. I think that the only series that I have some issues on is Dogcraft, because in that series, I use a lot of mods, and I also use shaders, and so sometimes I only get about 30 FPS in that series, which is okay, but it's not fantastic. But in everything else, I'm able to get well over 100 FPS while I'm recording, so I'm pretty happy with a Mac. Anyway, so let's move on, I guess, to some of the... I want to talk about some of the things that I use on the Mac. So for video editing, I use a program called ScreenFlow. It's about $100, and what's really great about it is that it records your screen and the audio from the game on your screen. It also records your microphone audio, so whatever microphone you have set up with ScreenFlow, whether it's the a headset or a microphone like I have, or the actual computer's microphone, and then you can also set it to record the face cam from the little built-in camera here, which I don't really do, but you could, and so that's why I recommend ScreenFlow. It's a simple program to use. I've actually thought about making a video where I actually show you guys how I edit an episode like of Dogcraft, so let me know in the comments if that's something you would like to see. In terms of photo editing, I recommend a program called Photoshop Elements. And a lot of people make the mistake and think that you need to buy Photoshop to use for like your YouTube thumbnails. And Photoshop is an incredibly expensive and complicated program, and I promise you, you do not need all of the functions of Photoshop to do YouTube thumbnails. You just need Photoshop Elements, and it's about $100 as well, maybe a little bit more. But I promise you, before I worked in YouTube, I worked with many, many graphic designers, and you don't need to spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars to have Photoshop. Photoshop Elements will get you by just fine, and that is what I use every single day. In fact, I have a trial of Photoshop downloaded right now, and every time it opens, I'm like, no, Photoshop Elements. Anyway, okay, moving on. Over here, I have my printer. This is a wireless printer and scanner. On top of it, I have a cactus because that is the only kind of plant that I can keep alive. And then I have these cute little crocheted Molly and Paige dolls. My keyboard is just the standard Apple wireless keyboard that connects with Bluetooth. However, what I will say about this keyboard is that it is very quiet. And so I recommend it to people because you never hear my keystrokes. My mouse is a Logitech wireless mouse. Everything on my desk is white, you'll notice. Like, my desk is white, my printer is white, my mouse pad is white. And that is because Paige and Molly hair and dust lands everywhere. And when I have black items, you see the dust, and it drives me crazy. Anyway, I've got these wrist pads here because I spend so much time on my computer that I really need to be careful that my wrists don't get that sore. I've had these for years, actually. I bought them off of Etsy. I think it's funny that they're mermaids and squids, or maybe those are octopi. Oh. Well, anyway, I like to think that they're squids. Okay, so I guess let's talk about my audio setup, because that's actually quite involved. And that was probably the most expensive setup here next to the actual physical computer. So this is a Rode microphone, pivot. I just invented a word. I was trying to merge pivot and swivel. So it's a pivot, a microphone mount, and I've got a shock mount here. This is an InVision shock mount. I've got a MXL USB microphone and a Wintech pop guard on it as well. Again, everything's going to be in the description. I've got a smartphone holder. This is so I can prop my phone up and use the stopwatch feature while I'm recording my videos. The case that I have on my iPhone is a case from a company called Uncommon with Dalmatians. I love it. Over here, I've got a little, this is a Tokidoki vinyl figurine that I saw at Comic-Con this year, and he is a bulldog wearing a cactus outfit, and this is actually very symbolic to me because a lot of times I read my YouTube comments, and some of them are quite nasty towards me, and so I like to look at this and think of myself as putting on my cactus costume before I go look at my comment section. I've got a Minecraft squid that I got at VidCon. And then this is a little tripod that you can use for the camera that I'm actually using to film this right now. It is just my go-to vlogging camera. It's a Canon PowerShot with a wide-angle zoom. I'll leave the full name of it in the description below, but I can put it on this little tripod and then set it up places. Okay, moving on. This TV, I mean, I guess it's a TV. It's kind of a monitor too. This is old. This is just something that I had lying about. I think it's a 23-inch Vizio LED. This is something I might need to replace soon because sometimes it just sort of shorts out. But this is what I'm using to view my Xbox, which is something new that I'm trying out. So I have an Xbox One underneath the desk here, and behind it is an Elgato, and that's what I use to capture the gameplay on the Xbox One. It plugs into the TV, and then it also plugs into my computer, so I can capture everything from there. And fun fact, my friend Joe, who goes by Stampy on YouTube, is actually the one who set up my Elgato. So I think that that's kind of a funny story. I don't think most people can claim that they have technical support from Stampy Longhead. Anyway, so over here I've got my filing cabinet where I just keep like all my equipment that I'm not using. And then here's my my elaborate Disney Infinity setup. I don't always have all of this set up. Right now I'm actually filming a video in partnership with Disney because actually, if you didn't know, my channel is signed with Maker Studios, which is now a part of Disney. That's another thing that I would probably say hold off on until you have over 100,000 subs. There's really no need for you to partner with a network. A lot of times smaller channels partner with a network thinking that that's what they need to do, and it's not. I think that, you know, once you have over a certain amount of subs, like 100,000, then you might want to look at networks, but otherwise I think you're perfectly fine just being a YouTube partner. But that's a whole nother topic. But anyway, I am partnered with Maker Studios because I'm here in Los Angeles, and I just realized I didn't talk about my headphones. Hold on. Anyway, I'm doing two videos for my channel that are going to be about the new Disney Infinity 2.0. So be on the lookout for those. Please watch them and like them and favorite them. It would really help me out a lot. But usually I just have Jesse here on the base. I don't usually have all of these figures out and about, but they're quite fun to look at, I think. Anyway, back to my headphones. These are just some Sony professional video editing headphones. I don't use gaming headphones anymore. I don't really care that much about the quality of the in-game sound for me. I care more about the audio for the editing process of the videos. And so these are kind of like the cheapest video editing headphones that you can get. If you don't know this about me, before I worked on YouTube, I actually worked for the company that owned Smosh and Smosh Games. And then before that I worked for, the Jonas Brothers, and a website that they had called Cameo that was, all videos. And so I've been around a lot of video editors, and these are just kind of like your standard, video editing headphones. Anyway, I think that's pretty much it. I'm going to talk briefly about the furniture that I have. The filing cabinet is from CB2. The lamp is from West Elm. The chair is also from West Elm. And my desk is from IKEA. It's just a very cheap, long desk. That was important to me, to have a long desk so that I could have all of this set up. And is there anything that I have? Oh, under here, this is where I have so much mail that goes to my P.O. box. Guys, I've been saving it all to open up on camera, and I just, I don't know, I need to just sit down and do it at one point. I've opened some of them so far, and I'm so excited, but I'm very sorry that I haven't opened all of it yet. It's coming soon, I promise. I've just been really, really overwhelmed over the last couple of months. But anyway, I think that that is everything that I have to show you. Oh, I have over here my work hard and be nice to people poster. And I have that over by my desk because I think it's just something that is very good to always remember. Anytime you're maybe feeling down about, you know, whatever, yeah, look at that and you're probably not doing one of them. that is my setup right now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I think I definitely would like to move it to a bigger setup in the future where maybe it's in its own dedicated room. This is in my bedroom. I have quite a small apartment. But for now, I think it works very, very well. Oh, I was going to talk a little bit about my organization too. I've got three products that I use back here to manage all of my cables. I've got these little gear ties that are like rubber twisty ties that you get on bread. But these ones are like rubber and they're reusable. And then I've got these Q-knots, which I do. They come in three different sizes. I have to lump together my bigger cables. And then I've got these little white cable drops to thread my cables through, and then they stick to the bottom of the desk. Just in case you were wondering how I keep all the clutter managed. But the dog hair is a separate story. I vacuum like once a day. anyway, that's going to be it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Again, I'm blown away that I have 300,000 subscribers on this channel. Thank you guys so much for completely changing my life and allowing me to do this every day in my pajamas, which I really appreciate. oh, my water bottle. I forgot. I just remembered because my throat is getting quite scratchy. But this is my new favorite water bottle. I always have a huge water bottle on hand when I'm recording my videos so that I can take a drink when I need to. And this one is really cool because it not only has a filter in it, but it also has this straw, so I don't have to tilt it at all. So I just pour tap water in this at night and then put it in the fridge. And then in the morning, I have this amazing, cool bottle of water. I think that's everything. I'm sure I forgot something, but that's gonna do it, I think, for this video. Thanks so much, guys, for watching. Until next time, Paige and Molly love you. Go rescue a dog. Nope, I remember what I forgot. So back here behind my iMac, I have this little shelf that screws onto the back of an iMac, and it holds my 2 terabyte external hard drive right up there. Okay, bye.